Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Okay. Srila Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj Ki. So we are celebrating 16th disappearance anniversary of Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. I was there 16 years ago on this day. Some of you, anyone else was there also? That day, 16 years ago? Yeah. What a loss. What a shock. Tamal Krishna Maharaj. Anyways, so much to. It's my dear brother. One time my GBC, when I was just a bhakta in Bombay, Tamal Krishna Maharaj was a GBC. Then I was a brahmachari, and one day he was very, very strict. And the GBC has to make sure all the standards are maintained. One day I was getting late to come to Mangalarti. So I hurriedly put my dhoti like a sannyasis do, not a brahmacharya style. I had no time to, I thought I should just, like gopis would just run, you know, when there's a hold upside down, and I thought that would be accepted, my ecstasies. So as I came to the temple and I was about to bow down to Tamal Krishna Maharaj. Walked closer to me, I offered my obeisances, and as I looked up, he was there. Are you brahmachari? Yes. Sannyasi dhoti? No. He said, go! I thought I could go after Mangalarti and do the. He said, no, now. And he stood there till I departed. Hari Hari. Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada gave him, I mean, he was only or sole GBC of entire India that time. I think he was the first GBC of India. Srila Prabhupada gave him sannyas in Jaipur at Radha Govind Temple. That's the time the queen of Jaipur also donated set of Radha Krishna deities. Prabhupada named them Radha Govinda and sent them to New York. New York Radha Govinda. So Tamal Krishna Maharaj had come back to Bombay, and in meantime something happened with me, and I was getting ready for marriage. It was arranged. Temple president was involved. And my parents were very happy, thinking that I was becoming normal. So they also had come, and everything was. But then, on the day of the ceremony, the girl's parents came, and they had parked the car some distance away from the temple. They said, some jewelry and saris for you, we have, please come to the car. They brought her to the car, made her sit down in the car. They kidnapped her. And I was very much down, thinking why bad things are happening to a good person like me. So my GBC took note that I was kind of undergoing some depression. So I'm very thankful to Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj for counseling me and lifting me up. And he proposed, he said, "You marry Krishna." And then idea of me taking sannyas kind of came out of that, marrying Krishna, take sannyas. So Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj ki. So then after several years in Bombay, he goes back to America, and the kind of book distribution that he managed, Srila Prabhupada's book distribution, the tidal wave, a revolution. He managed to get, well, he had 6 buses, 20 vans, and 150 brahmacharis with him. Some sannyasis also. And he named that party as Radha Damodar Party, distributing hundreds and thousands, amazing, and winning those marathons. And I think it must be around that time she had an idea of making offering unto Srila Prabhupada for Srila Prabhupada's pleasure. And he was thinking of offering a garland, not of flowers, but garland of jivas, souls. So he with his staunch, strong preaching, he made 108 devotees and made some kind of mala and offered them at Srila Prabhupada's feet. Haribol. It's quite a feat, right? He was, this land, the very first piece of land for ISKCON in Mayapur was acquired by Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. Prabhupada had assigned this task. Srila Prabhupada was in Kolkata, and he sends Tamal Krishna Maharaj to Mayapur, and he was very expert, and the great determination and whatnot, by hook or crook, he wanted to manage to get a piece of land from a Muslim sold. And Prabhupada was in Kolkata waiting. It was late in the night. Prabhupada was waiting and waiting. He was very anxious to know what was the outcome. Did he manage to purchase the land? Is the deal complete? He wasn't coming, so Prabhupada also was concerned. Why is he not here? Something went wrong. So as Tamal Krishna Maharaj had returned, lights were on in Prabhupada's quarter, knocking at the door in the middle of the night. As Prabhupada opened the door, Tamal Krishna Maharaj handed the paper. "Here is land for you, Srila Prabhupada. Mayapur land." Yeah, Tamal Krishna Maharaj was very much attached to Srila Prabhupada. There's so much affection for Srila Prabhupada, and he always preferred to be around Prabhupada, serving in a very special way, which he did in a very special way. Sometimes I think that Tamal Krishna Maharaj had some kind of access to Srila Prabhupada's mind and heart, knowing what is on Prabhupada's mind and in his heart. And then he would try to fulfill Prabhupada's wishes and desires. The final year, he wrote a book also, a drama about that also, a final year. Finally, final year. Huh? That's the name of the book. Final lesson. He wrote many books. Servant of the Servant is quite a book, biography of Srila Prabhupada, and the history of ISKCON, and TKG Diary is world famous, something that TKG knew, no one else knew, because there were just him and Srila Prabhupada a lot of times. So he was making notes, TKG Diary. So he had come since the Mayapur 77, and then from that time till 14th November 77 in Vrindavan, he never left Srila Prabhupada's company. He was like a shadow of Srila Prabhupada, going, following everywhere, and offering from here going to Bombay, an idea of going to Rishikesh, and Tamal Krishna Maharaj was involved. And then back to Vrindavan when Prabhupada thought, no, I may be leaving this world. So Tamal Krishna Maharaj managed. Bhaktijara Maharaj also was there in Rishikesh. And last year of Srila Prabhupada on the planet, Bhaktijara Maharaj also spent a lot of time with Srila Prabhupada and Tamal Krishna Maharaj. And when he was getting a little better, Prabhupada, the idea of traveling to America, going to Gita Nagari, came up, and Prabhupada was on the way to Gita Nagari, but then he stopped in London, and then his health went from bad to worse, and had to be rushed to Bombay, and then on to Vrindavan. And all this time, Tamal Krishna Maharaj was with Srila Prabhupada, the writing will of Srila Prabhupada, and Tamal Krishna Maharaj was instrumental getting that written. And on and on. Yeah, the mission of a very tough mission, frontier, China. When there were some difficulties in America, I think, interrelationship with different zones, and then Tamal Krishna Maharaj had to surrender his zone in America, and then he was, you go to China. And he was surrendered soul, and he did go to China, to the tough, hard nuts there. He did cracked, and we could see there's a bunch of, as I was coming down here, so many Chinese devotees here. Are there a few hundred Chinese devotees here right now? Right? Yeah. And of course there are thousands in China. So this was her work, initials, planting the seeds of Krishna consciousness in China. China was opened, and Krishna consciousness making inroads in China, the communist China. This was Tamal Krishna Maharaj's very special mission. And it was 2000, year which? 2002, right. 2002, Tamal Krishna Maharaj did something special. He had been doing that for a few years. He was conducting kirtans in his apartment. He had a large apartment in the conch building, which could accommodate like 400 or 150 devotees. And he was inviting them every night. You know, something like what was going on in Srivas Angan, with selected group of devotees, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was chanting and dancing. So Tamal Krishna Maharaj was organizing those kirtans night after night after night after night. Very amazing kirtans. I remember him going every day to Ganga also, those days where I stayed. I used to see him going to Jamuna, coming back from Jamuna every day. So the Kirtan Mela that has now had been happening in Mayapur and elsewhere also, I think I make connection that this is the Tamal Krishna Maharaj started those special kirtans in his quarters, and that was happening many years, year after year. Then after his departure, GBCs continued those kirtans, reading of Chaitanya Charitamrita and kirtans as a memory or remembering Tamal Krishna Maharaj and his programs, his activities of kirtan activities. And then gradually, kirtan melas started everywhere. And kirtan mela ki? Yeah. So kirtan melas, which are now happening in Mayapur, also has connection with what Tamal Krishna Maharaj did, the kirtans in Mayapur. So, and so all day there are the ceremonies celebrating Disappearance Festival of Tamal Krishna Maharaj, beginning at 10 o'clock. Community hall? Samadhi. His Samadhi. Tamal Krishna Maharaj's Samadhi? Tamal Krishna Maharaj's Samadhi, beginning at 10 o'clock. You're all invited, welcome to go there, offer your prayers, obeisances, hear his glories, chant and hear his glories, and like that, keep remembering this great soul, the great brother of mine and many of us. When Prabhupada departed, I felt certainly a loss, big loss. And one more time I had a similar feeling when Tamal Krishna Maharaj left. I also had the feeling of great loss, and it was Hari Hari. Yeah, I was told that before he left, he had offered his obeisances to Garuda. The morning that he left, offered obeisances to Garuda. And then, but he was not allowed to go outside Brajamandal realm. Before he could cross the Brajamandal border. Oh, okay. Non-different. Gauramandal. Then he was stopped. He was checked. No, you can't go out. Stay here. So we take that as Tamal Krishna Maharaj is here. He's in Navadvip, he's in Vrindavan. Or he's with Srila Prabhupada. He caught up with Srila Prabhupada that day. He is one of the parishions of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj Tirabhavati Mahasava Ki Jaya. Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj Tirabhavati Mahasava Ki Jaya. Srila Rasikadanand Prabhu Tirabhavati Mahasava Ki Jaya. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jaya. Nithai Gaur Premanande.